Hello and welcome to the online learning session Temperature Control of a Barbecue Smoker with ABB iBus KNX. In this online learning session, lasting a maximum of 30 minutes, the focus is on a special solution such as the integration of a barbecue smoker into KNX today. This is certainly an unusual but interesting application. I will show how this can be done with temperature sensors, a blower, analog input, switch actuator and push control touch. My name is Jürgen Schilder from the ABB Competence Center Europe Smart Buildings. Today I'm giving an extraordinary online learning session. My colleagues Martin Lichari and Stefan Große are also in their home office and Thorsten Reibel is on holiday. The session is recorded and then published. You get as always a feedback email together with the links to the presentation and the video recording. The RCC group is in the home office. Here you can see Martin, Thorsten, Stefan and me working from home. At the moment is our mission, working from home office to home office. I think many of you also work in the home office. We have already given some online sessions and will continue to give them and webinars in future. Now we come to the agenda. I would like to start with a short introduction about barbecue, where does it come from, so what is grilling, what is smoking. Then we come to the main topic, temperature and ventilation control of a typical barbecue smoker, and then to the measurement of high temperature, more than 200, 300, 400 degrees with the analog input and an additional analog transmitter. This year, the KNX Association is celebrating its 30th anniversary. And here you can see the well-known main advantage of KNX. KNX can be used for all kinds of projects. Apartments, schools, airports, hotels, office buildings. There are no limit in the size or kind of projects. KNX is the worldwide standard, European standard, American standard, Chinese standards. And it guarantees the interoperability between the different manufacturers thanks to neutral certification. We have only one software tool, the ETS software. KNX supports different media, twisted pair, KNX RF or IP, and can be also easy coupled to other systems like DALI, BACnet for example, or Modbus. And worldwide, we have more than 91,000 partners and more than 500 training settings. But the most important advantage is KNX can be used in all kinds of applications. Like for example light, shutters, blinds, HVAC and now also for barbecue, grilling and smoking. Here on the right side you can see all this field of applications and now what is new here is the KNX can be used also for barbecue, grilling and smoking. Especially in the current situation, now we have time for cozy barbecue with our family. The barbecue, you can grill or you can smoke. For example, we can use the fish or we can have spare ribs here in a typical smoker like here on the right side. And depending on the food, like for example a beef biscuit, it can last up to 12 hours in such a smoker. So, but then it requires also supervision. So we must go check the, measure the temperature and then control here also the airflow and regulate the temperature. In the next slides, I would like to show you how we can integrate such a smoker via the KNX barbecue controller box here with our KNX devices together with our KNX installation inside the building. Get also messages, for example, on the mobile phone or to operate it via mobile phone and how this complete application now works. So first, a few words about smoking. What's the difference between smoking and grilling? Smoking, we have our meat or the fish not direct above, for example, the coal or the charcoal, for example, or here the fire. Smoking means we have like here on the right side, we have here our typical barrel smoker, side firebox with the wood or for example the charcoal. And then via tube, the hot air goes here into the cooking room and here we have our meat or we have the fish. So this is the principle of smoking. So Smoking means we have also low temperature, temperature between 90 and 130 degrees. So we need more time. That's why we hear also slow cooking. And it comes maybe here from the from America, like here in the south of America, from the 18th or 19th century. They start here with smoking, like here in the pit. At the moment, there are different types of smokers available on the market. The most common is here the typical barrel smoker, but also a water smoker or the so-called UDS, ugly drum smoker, is available. So no size, no limit in the size of a smoker. So it depends on your family or your friends. You have here also possibility to use here a smoker truck with I think up to 4 tons of meat you can make here inside. So today I would put the focus here on this type of the typical UDS smoker because it's not difficult to integrate it into the KNX. But how does such a typical UDS ugly drum smoker works? At first it is based here, or it consists of a steel barrel, 200 liter barrel, typical size here. And then we have here on the ground inside, we have our ash pan. Then it followed by the charcoal basket with our charcoal, the coal, or sometimes also wood, which is burning very slow, or which glows very slow over really up to 12 hours. Then we have on the next level our water or sand bowl, which works like a heat store to compensate the temperature fluctuation. And you can see here the heat, which comes here from our charcoal, goes here on the left, on the right side, into our cooking space. So our meat here is not above here our charcoal, about our hot elements. So we cook it here indirectly. That's the difference. So additionally, we have here our two grill grates with the thermometer, so we can cook here. And additionally, here depends on the amount of our food, of our meat here, into tier two levels. And on the top, we have our drum lid with the two ventilation outlets, so the hot air can go here outside. So on the left, on the right side, or also on behind, we can have here our so-called pipes. And on the pipes, we have the ball valves. And with the position of the ball valves, we can regulate the airflow. And we are adjusting here the valves. We regulate how much air goes here inside. And then we can regulate the temperature. So this is a manual step we have to do, open or close the position of the valve to regulate here the temperature that we have always here between 100 and 120 degrees in such a typical UDS smoker. So here you can see the picture of a UDS smoker. The three pipes, like here, one right, one left, one is behind, and here these ball valves to regulate the airflow which goes here inside the UDS. And here's a picture. You see here the charcoal basket with the charcoal and or for example the coal. And here it's a bit not good to see. Here we have the opening which comes there, the air here inside on the three positions. Yeah, more air inside and temperature is rising, less air, and then the temperature falls down. So via regulation, the airflow, we can control our temperature. So this is the principle of such a UDS smoker. So, oops, was too fast. If my family, for example here, wants to have a beef brisket for lunch, what do I have to do? I have to start at midnight because beef brisket needs 12 hours and I must check the temperature regularly, maybe every 30 minutes, and adjust here we are this ball valve, the temperature. So, but this is not really fun to wake up every 30 minutes, go down and check the temperature. So what I have done, I have thought, okay, how is it possible to integrate this feature into KNX? And here you can see the solution. With some KNX devices, like an analog input, a switch actuator, and a control touch, we can integrate this smoker into KNX. So at first we measure here the temperature, and via a fan, the fan blows the air here inside, depending on the temperature. So, and after 6 hours, we have the perfect, for example, spare ribs, or 12 hours later, the perfect beef brisket. So now how it works step by step. Let's come at first to the so-called KNX barbecue controller box. So the barbecue controller box exists of a KNX power supply. I use it here as a separate KNX line with an analog input to measure the temperature, switch actuator to switch on and off the fan, and to control here some indicator lights. To show here the status, fan is on and off, or we have exceeded or fallen below our alarm thresholds, and the core temperature, for example here, is reached. So here you can see the analog, the temperature sensors, typical PT1000 temperature sensors. But how to connect or how to get the information into the building? I hope you have learned in your basic training, do not install KNX outside the building. Because someone can manipulate a KNX line, he can have access and do some strange things. So I found here a solution by using this so-called power LAN adapter. This comes here from a German manufacturer, it's available in Germany. Inside a building, I have here such an adapter connected to my IP network in the building. And then this adapter uses the existing power network to transmit the IP data. So an outside the building, I have the same adapter. And here you can see the network cable connected here to an IP switch, to my IP router, and so on. So it's possible to link outside this box via the IP router and this power LAN adapters to my building and to my KNX line. Oh, here we can measure, or here you can see the picture how we measure the temperature. So we use here the analog input. I use here the Dienwell component. We have also a surface mounted analog input. So we have here four inputs, so we can measure up to four different temperatures. So a typical sensor is here PT1000 temperature sensor, and then depending on the temperature, this temperature is measured here and then sent to KNX, and then we have the value available. So the analog input can be, we can connect different types of temperature sensors like a PT100, PT1000, or also KTY sensors in two-wire or three-wire technology. So you can select the type of sensor you have connected here. So the typical range of this analog input is between -50 and +150 degrees. This is enough because in a typical smoker we have temperatures between 90 and 130 degrees, and so we can use a standard sensor and measure temperature. So here, for example, on input A, then we have here our output value group object. This is a 2-byte with temperature in degrees Celsius. So then the input A sends here the temperature to KNX. This is how we can measure the temperature. This is not very difficult. Then let's come to the next feature, to the threshold function. Depending on the temperature, the flower should be switched on or off automatically. So we use the threshold function of an analog input. Each input of an analog actuator has two independent thresholds, threshold number one and threshold number two. So in the threshold, we can set at first our lower limit. Default, for example, we have here -500, so we have to multiply it by 0.1, which is -50, and the maximum is 150 degrees. So here you can set the lower and the upper threshold, and between we have here our hysteresis. So then we can say what should happen if the threshold falls below the limit or exceed our upper limit. Should we send a 1-bit telegram or also 1-byte with a fixed value? Also possible. So, and the behavior, which kind of telegram are on or are off when we fall below or if we succeed. This is a setting we can do here. Then you will see we get here the object, our threshold object. I set here a 1-bit object. Then we get here 1-bit. Typical switch. So what is also possible? To change here these limits, the lower and the upper limit. When we say here limits modifiable via bus, when we say yes, then we get two additional group objects. You see here threshold one, lower limit, upper limit, and via 2-byte telegram, a temperature value, we can change here our default threshold. Also possible. So depending on your food, what you have, meat, or the how many kilograms, you can change here, for example, the values. So now does such a typical threshold function work? When we have a look at the default settings, like we have it in a slide before, so we have here our threshold. We set the threshold, the upper limit, which is the orange one. We have the green one, which is our lower limit, and blue, we have here our measured value, for example. It can be air pressure, it can be a temperature, CO2 concentration, what do you want? So then depending on this value, we use the thresholds. So the first, we said, okay, when we exceed our upper limit, then the threshold object sends the value 1 to the bus. Then maybe the threshold, the value goes still rising. Then he falls below our upper limit, but nothing happens. We are here in our hysterese. Only one when the value falls below the lower limit, like here, and then he sends the value 0. This is the behavior of the threshold. The value must exceed the upper limit and fall below the lower limit. Between here, between the upper and the lower limit in the hysterese, nothing happens. So this is very important. This is the typical behavior of the threshold. And I have used it in my smoker exactly for this feature, to switch on and off the blower depending on the temperature inside the smoker. You see here the two temperature sensors, which goes inside for the first level, another level. And here on the, I have opened here this valve, the ball valve, and the blower blows here the air inside the UDS smoker. All other ball valves are here closed. So then depending on the temperature and the threshold function, the blower is automatically switched on and off. And this is not a special blower. This is a blower which costs 2-3 euros and it comes from a 3D printer. So it's a very cheap solution. And then depending on the threshold, when he falls below the lower limit, the threshold send the value 1 and the switch actuator switch the blower on and blows air inside and the temperature is rising. When you reach our upper level or exceed the upper level, and then the threshold function send the value 0, opens the relay and the blower stops blowing air inside. That's a typical behavior here of the threshold function. So let's go here to the settings. So we enable here our threshold number 1. We set here our temperature value, like for example the lower limit 122 degrees and our upper limit 128 degrees. We want to modify the values via bus, yes, so we say here yes. And then we have to set the behavior, what should happen when the temperature value falls below 121 degrees, switch on the blower, and if the value exceed our upper level, and then he should switch off. So these are the typical settings here of the threshold function number 1. So I use another threshold function for alarm notification. For example, what should happen? Or I want to have the information when the fire goes out, for example. Or something went wrong with my blower. The blower blows still air inside and the temperature is rising more than 140 degrees or falls below 110. So we can use another threshold function, like here a lower threshold limit of 110 degrees. And the upper threshold alarm limit of 140 degrees. So when this temperature really is here ranged, like the fire goes off, then I get automatically a notification via the control touch to my smartphone, a push notification, then I know, oh, I have to wake up at 3 o'clock and check something is wrong here with my UDS smoker. Additionally, a small buzzer is also switched on, so I can hear also the sound maybe during the day when I'm outside in my garden is also possible. So this is with a second alarm threshold, with a lower limit or here an upper limit. Good, for the visualization of the complete UDS smokers, all the value or to change, for example, the thresholds, I use here the push control touch. Push control touch is connected to KNX, to the IP network, so I can also here integrate the ABB IP cameras. And the communication to my smartphone and to my tablet is here via Wi-Fi. So on this slide, here you can see, for example, the temperature, 127 degrees. This is the temperature measured via the PT1000 sensor. Then the threshold, if it's below the threshold or if it has exceeded the upper threshold limit. And the status of the blower, at the moment you see the blower here is on. And via the next two buttons, I can change here my upper limit and the lower limit. So via plus minus, I can change it here, and then the control touch sends the two byte values to the analog input and change here the thresholds. Plus some more informations I can see here of the other temperature sensors. So the control touch offers also here the diagram, so I can record here, for example, the last 2 hours, the temperatures, and you see here the temperature is going up and down. You see here between 130 and 180, 190. So it is using here the threshold function. So we see here 128 degrees, this is my upper limit for the threshold, and 122, this is the lower limit. So, and blue here, this is the threshold object for switching on and off the blower. So like here, the temperature is falling down, falls below the lower threshold, like 122. Then what happens? The threshold object sends here the value 1 and switches on the blower. Then of course it needs some minutes until the charcoal begins more glowing and the temperature now here is rising. When the temperature reaches the 128 degrees, my upper limit, then the threshold function send the command off, value 0 to the bus and switch off the blower. And some minutes later, again, the temperature falls below the lower limit and so on. And then the temperature you will see here is in this range between 118 and maximum 130 degrees. So it's completely automized. I have to do nothing. I have not to check the temperature or open manually the ball valves. Everything here is controlled by KNX. So this is the principle here of this threshold. So additionally, we can see also the pictures of IP cameras. The control touch, we need here only the URL string of the camera, and then I have here also a visual check if everything here is okay with my barbecue smoker. So how to link the group objects? Let's set here an overview. So on the left side, you can see the analog input with input A, which is used for blower control, and the input B with a second temperature sensor for the alarm notifications. So on the right side, the switch actuator, output A with the connections here to the blower, and output B, I have here connected a small buffer, and the control touch. The control touch is configured via the My Buildings portals, that's why you cannot see here the typical group objects like in the ATS. Good, okay, then let's start. At first, we create a group address, link it here from the input A temperature value to the control touch, and then we see the current temperature in the smoker. So for the threshold function, we use the one bit object. So we'll link it with the switch actuator to the object switching to switch on and off the blower, and the same to the control touch. Then we can see here also threshold has exceeded the upper limit or is fallen below the lower limit. So if I want to modify the upper and the lower limit, then I create two other group addresses, and via the control touch, I can send here the values and modify here the threshold upper and lower limit. You see that it's all. The only thing is, if you want to see the status that the blower is on off, we can link also here group address from the status objects of the output A and link it here also to the control touch. So the next step is for the alarm functions. I use a second temperature sensor and link the group address also here to the control touch, and the output for the threshold 1 and 2 is linked here to the channel B of the switch actuator to switch on here the buzzer and send here then via the control touch alarm notification. So we can use here this alarm message in the control touch, then you can send also push notification to the smartphone or to the tablet, and then I know, oh, I have to check something is wrong, maybe the fire is off or something. To modify here the alarm limits for upper and lower limit, I can also send here telegrams via the control touch to the analog input. That's all. We don't need more group addresses. Good. So far, we can control a smoker. And now we come to the second topic, the measurement of high temperatures with an analog input with additional analog transmitter in a barbecue grill. So directly, you have learned before, we can connect temperature sensors, PD100,000, and we can measure temperatures between minus 50 and plus 150 degrees Celsius. But in special applications, like when we want to make here drumsticks, Yeah, or a cherry cheesecake or salmon or bread, we need a temperature 180 degrees, 200 degrees or 220 degrees. So now we can measure this temperature more than 150 degrees. Like here in a typical grill, it's only to measure the temperature because here we have no possibility maybe to regulate the gas flow, yeah, or because here we are these knobs, you have to manually set the temperature. But this is for me very important. I can set here manually the temperature and then I want to see this temperature here in my grill inside the building, for example, on my smart touch. How we can do it? How we can expand this temperature range? Or for example, you have special applications in the building like the combustion engines, you have more than 150 degrees or something else, you can do the same. Yeah. In principle, we need here a so-called analog transmitter. This is a device, I have bought it here in a German company, SensorShop24DE. I'm sure it's also available in your country. And with this device, we can expand the temperature range of an analog actuator. So depending on this analog transmitter and the temperature sensor, which is connected to this analog transmitter, we can expand temperature range, like for example, between minus 100 degrees up to 50 degrees, from 0 to 200 degrees, or for example, from 0 to 400 degrees. That's what I have used in my barbecue grill, because sometimes I can have 250 degrees or 300 degrees. Yeah, that's why I think this here is the best value which fits for a barbecue grill. So and how does it work? So here inside this analog transmitter, we have a dip switch, and via the dip switch, we can set the measuring range. So like here, I have connected a PD1000 temperature sensor with a range from minus 50 up to 500 degrees. This is what he can measure. I've connected it to the analog transmitter. And in the analog transmitter, I have selected this dip switch. One is on, two is off, and so on. Then I have here selected this range 0 to 400 degrees. So what does it mean? This analog transmitter, he has an output signal. It can be a voltage signal, 0 to 10 volt or 4 to 20 milliamps. It depends on the hardware of this analog transmitter. And then this temperature value I have set here now is mapped to the analog signal. So what does it mean? When I select here exactly this measuring range, then 0 degrees means 0 volt and 400 degrees means 10 volt. So I have a linear relationship here between the temperature and my output signal. So how we do this? First step is we set the measuring range in our analog transmitter, for example, 0 to 400 degrees. And then we go here to our channel A, for example, sensor type. Here we say current or voltage or resistance. So then we get some more parameters, like for example, sensor output. We say sensor output. It depends on your analog transmitter, 0 to 10 or 4 to 20 milliamps. I prefer 0 to 10 because I can measure or control it via a digital multimeter. I say, okay, 0 to 10 volt is my signal. I want to send the value as a 2-byte floating value as a temperature to KNX. And I have at the next step to define my measuring range. Like for example, from 0 to 400 degrees. This is my measuring range, my output value. And and the next step, I have, for example, here to set the percentage of the lower measured limit, like from 0% to 100% is here adapted to 0 to 400 degrees. And then I have here on the left side, you can see it, a linear relationship. At 0 degrees, I have 0 volt output. And on 400 degrees, I have 10 volt. So here 100% of 10 volt and here 0% of the voltage. So this is the typical settings when we have here a temperature range between 0 and 400 degrees. Additional, we have, furthermore, we have our special functions, of course, yeah, but here this is only the settings to extend here our temperature range. So here's the example how I use it in my barbecue grill. So I have here a layer roast with turkey meat layered with sheep's cheese, yeah, chilies, onions, yeah, and other things. So I measure here the core temperature, because I need here minimum about 78 degrees of core temperature, and then here the layer roast is ready for lunch. So additionally, I measure here inside The grill space the temperature by using here a PT1000 temperature sensor connected here to my analog transmitter. So my input A, which is my core temperature, I need no analog transmitter because the core temperature is lower than 150 degrees, and then I can connect here a standard PT1000 core temperature sensor. So only with the second sensor I want to measure more than 150 degrees, and then I can use here the analog transmitter. So then I send here the temperature values inside my building, and I see here on the smart touch in my living room the temperature of the grill temperature at the moment 198 degrees measured by this sensor here. And if I want via these sliders, I can change here the lower limit or the upper limit. So like for example, 190 degrees is the lower limit, and when the temperature falls below 190 degrees, I get alarm message. Yeah, like the gas bottle is empty. It's good to know. And on the right side, I see here the core temperature. This is then my first sensor here. So at the moment, I can see here 72 degrees. And via the sliders, I can change here the thresholds of the core temperature. So like for example, when I reach here the 78 degrees and I get here info message, like beep, 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 then I know it's okay. Wow, core temperature is reached. Let's call the family. Lunch is, for example, ready. So this is the values I see here, or I can change here via the smart touch. But this is not all. We have to monitor not only our grill or smoker, but what about our meat, our tomahawk steaks, or the spare ribs, or the salmon, which is in the freezer or the refrigerator. We have to monitor also these devices. You don't want to harm here our meat, when there maybe there's power failure or the refrigerator has a device failure. So we have two possibilities to monitor it. One is, for example, similar. We use temperature sensors and install these temperature sensors inside the freezer or the refrigerator. From the back, sometimes it's possible to have a small opening to put here inside the temperature sensor. Then we use again a standard temperature sensor and the analog input. Here is an example, the analog input surface mounted. Here we have the same parameters, thresholds, like the DINRAL component, but the limitation here, we have only two inputs, not four, like the DINRAL component. So this is the first, then we use the same thresholds and so on. The second possibility is we use here additionally an energy actuator or the energy module. So these devices can measure the energy demand of the connected load, like here the freezer or the refrigerator. So, and we use again the thresholds of this energy actuator. He has also threshold function. Then we can set here maybe a limit. So the refrigerator or the freezer needs a minimum load. Let's say, for example, load consumption of 20 watts. And when there is a device failure, he stops working and then he needs no more power. And then we get here also alarm message via the energy actuator or energy module and send it here to the control touch. And then you are informed on your smartphone that, for example, your freezer here has a device failure or something. So this is an additional feature. We can also integrate not only grilling and smoking, only here to monitor your food, your steaks, tomahawk steaks, and the salmon in the refrigerator or in the freezer. Finally, a short summary of the integration of a barbecue smoker into KNX. Grilling now is more fun thanks to KNX. So we can say smart grilling today. No matter what is grilled, like here our lamb racks, our chickens, or waffles, T-bone steak, pineapple, salmon, or here the tomahawk steaks, no limitation. Thanks to KNX, we have a high level of comfort. So we need no manual supervision. Go and test the temperature and open the ball valve for more air to increase the temperature. No, everything works automatically. Thanks KNX, our blower. We reduce the energy demand because the consumption of charcoal is reduced. We have a safe system. When we have, for example, a problem, the fire goes off or something, then we get information to via the control touch to our smartphone. It is flexible, depending the type or quantity of meat. We can change here the thresholds via the smartphone, for example, or via the smart touch. And of course, we have every time an eye on the system for visualization, like, for example, our IP cameras. I think it's really a nice solution for KNX, the integration of grilling and barbecue. And next time I will subscribe here for the KNX award, and I hope you will vote for this solution. Good, now we come to the end of this online learning session. This time we talked about a special solution in a different way. Yeah, normally we have really technical applications and parameters and not such a practical solution here. Everyone know now, for example, what is a threshold, how a threshold works, and how you can use such a typical threshold. And everything shown here really is real, not a fake. So some colleagues have already visited me for barbecue, and I'm looking forward to more barbecues and a cold beer with one or the other of you. I think we are at the end. Yeah, then we come to the final slides. You can find all information about KNX on our website, abb.com/KNX. You can go to products and downloads, and you get all the information about the devices, the ETS application, product manuals, and so on, as always. All our information you can find in our training qualification database. Yeah, go to abb.com/KNX, and then you click forward to the database, or here you use this link. All our e-learnings, the presentations, the video tutorials, webinar slides from all webinars and online learning sessions we have given before. All the videos are also available on YouTube. So about our training, at the moment, all presence trainings are stopped. Let's see if it's possible that we can continue in the second half of this year. Yeah, we have here a training calendar with all our planned trainings up to the end of the year. Our next planned training in July is the KNX Advanced Course in Heidelberg, the 5-day training according to the KNX standards. Let's see if it's possible that we can do this. Or in October, our tutor course, and again, a basic course in November, maybe for some new colleagues or for new partners. Yeah, to get started with KNX, it's recommended to join here the so-called basic course. We still continue also with our webinars. Webinars last about 1 hour, and we talk about more details. So the next is about, again, DALI, emergency light. How we can connect these emergency converters, what is an emergency converter, how EMA tested, battery test, function test, the ETS parameters, group objects, and how we can use here also the IBUS tool. So it will take place on the 10th of June. You get, as always, invitation to this webinar, and you can subscribe. It's in the morning, 9 o'clock, and the afternoon, 3 o'clock, here in the German summertime. And of course, we continue here with our online learning sessions for a special topic. Thorsten will continue on the 4th of June with the combi switch actuators with the special topic shutter functions. So it's not only a switch actuator, it's a combination of switch and shutter, and here we'll talk about these shutter functions. And of course, more will follow. If you have still some topics or you want to know some special features of a device, yeah, or software applications, then please let it us know. Send the email here, yeah, to our special email address or directly to Martin, Thorsten, or me. I would like to thank you for your participation. Have a nice day. Now I'm going to the grill and making a T-bone steak for dinner. Goodbye and stay healthy.